President-elect Trump has a huge challenge, and that would be uniting a very divided nation. A CNN ORC poll that just 40% of Americans approve of how Trump is handling the presidential transition. The tensions will be on full display this weekend when thousands are expected to protest in Washington, D.C., just a day after Trump is sworn in as president. But Mr. Trump has managed to win over some former high-profile opponents, including NFL Hall of Famer Jim Brown, a former Hillary Clinton supporter. Brown is co-hosting a pre-inauguration day party tomorrow, and he joins me now live. Thank you so much for being with me, and it's such an honor to meet you.
Thank you for having me.
So awesome to have you here. That's right. That's
right. A lot of background there.
So much, so much. So you're going to be hosting this party. Who's going to be there?
Oh, my goodness, we'll have a lot of celebrities, Ray Lewis, probably Curtis Martin, and, you know, many other high-profile individuals. Bruce Zolan out of Ohio, Phantom Fireworks, a great supporter. Monique Brown, my wife, she's a great worker for the community. A lot of wonderful people, you know, a cross-section of great people that want to see our country, you know, get back on track.
So what do you hope, what message do you hope that your party, with such high-profile guests, will send to America?
Well, actually, we will show that there are people that, without getting any type of reward, is for this country, doing the right thing, developing opportunity for those who are underprivileged, that are not privileged to be rich and to be in the upper echelon. There are a lot of individuals that are killing each other in these communities around the country, but you hear nothing about it. And so we're going to be addressing poor people, African Americans that are trying to get an equal opportunity. And that's my goal. And I think that's a worthy goal.
You know, many African Americans are angry at Mr. Trump right now for his ongoing fight with Congressman John Lewis. You know, this morning, Mr. Trump called John Lewis a liar, and it goes on. What do you think about that?
Well, I'm glad you asked me about that. John Lewis has a great history as a civil rights fighter. As a young man, he was one of those guys out there that really was leading the parade during the King era. And so we all respect his history. But when I hear him cry the blues about Mr. Trump and saying that it's an illegitimate presidency, I take offense at that. If it's illegitimate, why is it going on? If you're going to impeach him, impeach him. If he did something wrong, arrest him. But don't cry the blues because you did not get the vote out. And this man had a genius way of winning the election.
Do you think that Congressman Lewis should sit down with Donald Trump?
Absolutely. Why not? Because it's in the best interest of the country. It is not good for people just to complain about something they had a part in and polarize the country. If I would leave and sit down as Jim Brown and complain about Donald Trump, what good would that do the country? But if I get out, regardless of who the president is, and try to contribute what I have to contribute and what my like-minded partners have to contribute, then we can look forward to the change and help the change.
So all of these lawmakers, Democratic lawmakers, and there's 52 now, I think, who are boycotting the inauguration, do you think they ought to go?
Of course they should go. They should respect the position. If the election was legal, if he is the president of the United States, they should go. We are Republicans, Democrats, so forth and so on, but we are human beings, and there are a lot of people that need us to get along so that we can help the people that can't help themselves.
Well, I look forward to hearing coverage of your party, and thank you so much for stopping by.
Thank
I do appreciate it.
Thank
you so much.
Thank you very much.